Good morning. Hope that all of you are happy after attending the term 1 examination. Let us continue learning the second chapter of your economics textbook. The topic that we are going to discuss today is education in India. When the exam was conducted on 19th August 2020, we had asked these questions as multiple choice questions. Here you can see all the questions which were descriptive in nature. I am very happy to share this information with you that most of you have performed well in the examination. Now let us continue learning. So, the second chapter in your textbook asks these questions. Has literacy rate increased in India since 1951? We had learned earlier that government had increased its spending on education. Definitely the answer to this question is literacy rate in India was less than 18% in 1951 and it has become 74% in 2011 according to some latest survey conducted by National Statistical Organization of India. The literacy rate of India has become 77%. But there is a vast difference across different sections of population. Literacy rate among males is nearly 50% higher than females and it is about 50% higher in urban areas. There are regional imbalances. 96% literacy rate is there in some districts of Kerala, whereas literacy rate is very low and it is below 30% in some parts of Madhya Pradesh. Based on some data published by National Statistical Organization yesterday, that is 7th September 2020, India's literacy rate has increased to 77.7%. And it says Kerala is the most literate state in India with 96.2% of literacy rate. And Andhra Pradesh is the state with the lowest literacy rate in India with 66.4%. And you can see the states with high literacy rate on the left side and states with the low literacy rate on the right side now. Even though the public expenditure on education has increased in India, there are many issues related to education which remain as unsolved. The primary education system has extended to over 5 lakh villages in India. But as you had studied in class 7, there is high dropout rates in India. In many states like Jharkhand and all, we are facing the problem. There is poor quality of schooling, another problem that we are facing. And thus government decided to focus on elementary education. Government thought of providing free and compulsory education to all children in the age group of 6 to 14 years. And for that, government implemented a program. And that program is known as Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan focuses on universalization of primary education. It has been operational in India since 2001 economic year. It aims to help around 206 million children. Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan program was pioneered by the former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee. Government noticed that only 6% of the people of India in the age group 18 to 23 are attending colleges in India. So, government decided to increase the number of these people who are attending colleges in the age group 18 to 23. As a result of it, what happened? that we can see in the next part of learning this module. As a result of implementing various programs by different governments, there has been a tremendous increase in the number of colleges, number of universities, number of students and teachers in India. That you can see from this table. In 1950-51, number of colleges was only 750. And it became, that means number of colleges increased to 41,435 in 2015-16. You can see the increase in the number of colleges, universities, students and teachers from this table. That's all for the time being. Thanks for listening.